Welcome back to our community. Suzie Thomas visiting with Sarah Farron, who is Missions Director at Faith from Family Church, talking about what the church does in the community. And Faith Family is not alone. We've got wonderful churches who serve people in the community. But what's some great examples that you are coming up with, and particularly this partnership with Canton City Schools and the Hope Chest? Now, I wanted to ask you one more thing about this. We're talking about clothing and shoes and, you know, everything, all you need to get going and get a child ready for school. What about school supplies? Do they accept these too, or is that another project for another day?
They do. The Hope Chest has school supplies, and it would gladly receive donations of school supplies, as well as personal hygiene products. In fact, our women's gathering, Flourish, we meet a couple of times a year. Last year, when we were sort of working on this back-to-school clothing drive, they caught wind of this, and they said, we want to engage with this project a little further. And so our women's gathering, when they met last fall, they collected over 1,000 boxes of feminine hygiene products to help serve the girls in that district.
And you just don't think about that. Right. It's just not on your mind. But how easy, whenever you're in the grocery store, to pick up a box or two and then donate. And then, boy, it makes a world of difference for someone, doesn't it?
It sure does.
Oh, my goodness. And I'm thinking also just how good you feel when you start with a new pen, a new notebook, and just start fresh. You kind of reinvent yourself.
Right.
Maybe you had a rough year last year. It's a new day.
It's a new day, yeah. And the great thing about this resource is that it's available all throughout the school year.
Mm. Tremendous. Well, tell us a little bit about these women now. I know that they've got a conference coming up in the fall. We want to get on people's calendars. So
yes.
Tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, you'll be hearing a lot more about our women's conference. It'll be on September 16th and 17th. We'll have some guest speakers come in. It's always such a great time when the women can just kind of get away, sort of shut off the rest of life, and just experience God together.
You mentioned Flourish. I know we've just recently had Flourish, but tell us what takes place. You know, let's go a little deeper when these women get together.
Sure.
I know you've participated in these. Mm-hmm. Tell us about some of the past conferences or Flourish times.
Yeah. So again, those are just times where we can encounter God, and the events are simple, but they're designed specifically with women in mind. So we talk about different topics that are important: managing your time, finding even sometimes getting wrapped up in so many of the responsibilities that we have as women. It can be hard to just even find what is my purpose and am I being effective. And finding ways to just encourage women to be who God called them to be, take their place, but then encountering Him in those really precious, intimate times of worship. And so we have some really great times of worship together. Our worship leaders are incredible, and just lead us to a place where we can just know that God's near.
Women can be very hard on other women.
Mm.
And the church is no exception. So how refreshing to think of a time where women are getting encouraged by other women in the church.
Yeah, and I think that's one of the emphasis that we place is with small groups. We have women's groups, and I'm telling you, those have been such a blessing to the women in our church to come together. And we have some groups that, you know, it's maybe you're in a similar stage of life, and you can talk about those things that where you're at in life. And then we have other groups that are maybe a little mixed with older and younger and different backgrounds and different experiences, so that you can sort of learn from others. And so really whatever fits your needs or your interests, those are available. But all of them are exactly what you said, ways to encourage, bring women together, encourage them in whatever stage of life they're in, and help them just to know God in a deeper way.
And women weren't the only ones who jumped on board with the Hope Chest project. You also, some men said, hey, don't leave us out.
They would not be outdone by the women. And so actually at the men's event, it's called Fight Club. They have a few events throughout the year as well. They're fighting for what it means to be a godly man, and a really incredible vision for what they have there. But they said, you know what, we want to be a part of that as well, and investing in the next generation. They actually received an offering, and then they had to put their hands to something. And so they built the shelves and took the racks, the clothing racks, put those together, assembled those, and bought some bins and hangers and some supplies to just really help that Hope Chest be what it needed to be.
So you go into the room, and it really doesn't seem like a classroom with clothes piled up here and there, does it?
It feels like a little store. It's everything set up. It's so nice. I mean, and the racks are packed with nice clothes. So it's not just a little bit here and there. It's packed with nice clothes. It's very well organized. Kelly has a team that works on that on a regular basis, and it's a great resource.
We have very generous listeners, so remind us again how someone can donate to this.
Yes, so if you'd like to donate, you can contact Kelly Perry at Canton City Schools. She's the homeless liaison. Her phone number is 330-438-2563.
You have an interesting prison congregation and ministry to prisoners.
Yes.
Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, so that's something that's just been on our pastor's heart for a while to reach our prisons in even a greater way. We've had a prison ministry locally, and then even a little bit out of our region. We've been ministering in prisons and local jails for a long time. And just in the last several months, we've been able to launch a campus inside the prison facilities. It might sound like a unique model, but it's working so well. The women who attend, about 100 women attend at the Northeast Reintegration Center in Cleveland every week. They watch via big screens. They assemble about 100 women, and they truly are part of Faith Family Congregation. They just meet at a different site. And I'm telling you, the stories that are coming from within that prison, the life change and the hope, it's incredible.
That's hard not to get teary.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll quickly ask another question. You've got a big event coming up in July, another more partnership with organizations in the community. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, so we're working with the United Way of Greater Stark County. We're really excited about this. In July, we want to do just a one-day sort of service event where we have the opportunity to mobilize our congregation and sort of let them put their hands to the plow, so to speak, and do something to help serve our community. So one of the things that we really believe strongly is that those short-term projects are really great, but they're best when they serve long-term vision. And so that's why we wanted to partner with the United Way and sort of tap into their broad network of solid relationships and solid partners, so that as we sort of set up opportunities to serve in the community, we know that we're working alongside, like I said, true heroes who are in the trenches, putting their hands to the plow every day. We want to just come along, find ways to come alongside and support what they're already doing.
So United Way, which combines a number of organizations, and I'm going to address this, bit of an elephant in the room. I know that there are many wonderful Christian people who have trouble with United Way because of the past history of having Planned Parenthood be a part of that. That is no longer the case in our United Way, in our community. That hasn't been for several years. So just to address that, if you have concerns about partnering with United Way because of that issue, that's no longer an issue. So we move forward, and they do contribute to, oh my goodness, you name it, the organizations, YWCA and various homeless shelters are all part of United Way. And one single spot to be able to give, and then they disperse the money and find the needs and provide. So you are providing manpower. Any idea of what the kinds of things that you'll be doing on that day?
You know, we're kind of in those initial stages where we're gathering those opportunities, because one of the things we really want to do, instead of coming in to say, here's what we want to do, someone make it happen for us, we really want to say what are some of the needs. And so we're driving this. Our small groups are really going to be the ones that drive this. We're encouraging our whole congregation to participate at some level, and really saying, hey, don't serve alone. Come with your Connect group and don't serve alone. Let's just jump in and do this together. And so I think that as our small groups begin over the next several months to talk about it and think about what maybe gift sets they have or interests they have, I really believe that there's going to be opportunities for everybody to get on board and do something that they're excited about.
Somebody might be hearing and they're saying, you know, I'm brand new to the community. I have not really plugged into a church family or a church home yet. And this sounds like a great way to get involved. It's taking place July 16th. And does someone need to belong to Faith Family to participate, or can anybody?
You don't necessarily need to belong. I mean, it's going to be an online sign-up tool that's going to be offered through Faith Family. So come check us out. That's how you'll find out information about how you can jump in and be part of that. The cool thing is that it's not just Faith Family doing this, but this serve day on July 16th is actually happening with hundreds, maybe thousands of churches all around the country on that same day, serving their communities. It's going to look a little different in every community because we want to serve, you know, where our community genuinely has those needs. But we'll be participating with others, serving their community, just finding a way, again, to mobilize our church to reach out, to love and serve our community.
And it's really the church being the church, isn't it?
That's right.
The website again is?
You can go to myfaithfamily.com to find out a little bit more about our church or to connect with us.
Perfect. Sarah, tell us a little bit about why you think it's so important that a church do these kinds of things. I mean, what's wrong with just showing up on Sunday and singing a few hymns and going out and living better lives?
Yeah, you know, that's really an easy thing to do. And so actually sometimes with our busy lives, it's even a hard thing to do to be at church.
But why does service need to
sure.
be a part of
and,
it?
And putting when you put your hands to something, especially when you put your hands to something alongside somebody else, mm-hmm. you build relationships. But I think it also gives you a better perspective on your own life. Sometimes it's easy to be very internally focused. We look at maybe, you know, what our own calendars have listed and what we have going on. And it's easy when you're looking at that to feel, in a sense, disconnected. It's easy to feel like the problems in your life are bigger than they are. When you can get your focus off of what's going on in your own life and begin to serve others, there's something exhilarating. There's something exciting, and there's something almost freeing about that as you just know that what you're doing is making a difference for someone else, puts things into perspective, allows you to serve the community and others, does something inside of you. It's mm-hmm. hard to explain.
That's beautifully said, and we are always happier when we're not thinking about ourselves, huh?
Yeah. One thing we always say is that, you know, God's put a gift set. He's put gifts on the inside of each of us. Mm-hmm. We really believe that they're best utilized when they're used to serve other people.
This position, we only have about a minute left, but this position for you is kind of new, right? Mm-hmm. As far as the local serving, calling people, saying, how can we help?
Yes.
For you personally, how fulfilling has this been?
You know, I love it. It's the joy of my heart to be able to find ways to leverage what we have as a church in the community and to truly make a difference.
Mm-hmm. Sarah Farron is Missions Director at Faith Family Church. We want to remind you of a couple of things that you might want to belong to and get involved with. The Canton City Schools Hope Chest. And again, contact Canton City Schools. You can take things down to the old Timken High School, and they've got rooms set up as stores, and very happy to receive any clothing or school supplies or hygiene items that you might be willing to purchase and take there. That would be great. And then we also want to remind everybody about the Serve Day with United Way taking place July 16th. Sarah, thank you so much for joining us. And thank you for listening and tuning in today to our community.